You mentioned reverse engineering. So
reverse engineering, yeah.
Yeah. Does it just make video or produce a 3D CAD model?
3D model, yeah.
CAD model.
I will show you later a video. I have a video of this construction method. How it works. I will show you later. Yeah.
So, excuse me, maybe as a continuation from his question, this can be also related to 3D printer, actually, after the model.
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
Sure. You have a 3D model and then you can print it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Another question for the field. So, I have to report about the transmission. Can we define that transmitted inside the specimen? I mean, all this condition.
The question is, do they also record videos?
Yes.
Right, so we can see the some molecules in action.
Right. No, it's not an electron microscope.
So what do you mean with video? I mean,
scanning the surface. You mentioned storage is quite big. So one scan of one.
Depends. Depends on which magnification you need. If you make an A4 paper on magnification 5, you will have like maybe 2 gigs. If you have like a painting with magnification 500, you will have 1 terabyte.
So, what is the maximum gabarit or the model that can be scanned?
With the roach we had or with the 2D?
Generally, let's say if you do reverse engineering, can you reverse, let's say, this glass? That big, or what's the maximum?
I think the maximum for now is like this.
Like that?
Yeah.
The sample you have?
Yeah, this is like the maximum for now.
Yeah.
Because we're still working on it, it's still a very new thing we're working on. So basically you just need to change the lens and to change the magnification, and then you can do also bigger objects. So this is the revolver lens. I will show you this one now with a few samples.
Is it possible to measure surface roughness? So
yes. We have RA and RZ included in here, And if you need the surface roughness, which is getting more and more important for the optical optical side, you can do it with. That's a small bug. It's a new software, so I just need to.
Roughness is certified by us in ISO, so you can really present it officially the results.
Standard terminology you get.
Standard,
They are going to make right now the materials.
So I'm sorry for that. This is still a better version. Software. We're still testing other things.
So, you need new software for more resolution or for preview? You said it's new software for for higher resolution or?
The software, the basic software of the microscope. This one, which I had installed last week, is Japan sent me the new software to test it. And now we're testing, and there are some bugs appearing, and we need to report to Japan those bugs, and we need to change this a bit. So basically, we're working on the software every day. Great, so we'll do some measurements. Here, so we can see a nice height difference. So in this case, I adjusted the microscope to an interval of 12 microns. So the z-axis is now moving from up to down in 12 micron steps. You can see it because it's really small steps, but it's moving. You see it in the picture. And he's generating 36 images, and then he's going to lay them all over. It's called image stacking. And he's also saving the height data of the movement of the z-axis. And this is how you get the 3D profile. So this is the multifocus image. And now I can open it as a 3D profile. I'll change the color so you can see the height difference. So this is the basic 3D profile, and here I can do different measurements. For example, for the depth of this, I can do it automatically. I will just click max and min, and I get the result of 142 microns. Or I can tell it, okay, I need more exact, I need to go here, for example, and tell them, okay, this is 120 microns. For roughness testing, the same. I just need to adjust the cutoff value, and I don't know which kind of values you're using. Europe is usually 0.8, but you can adjust whatever you need, and just add it to the table, and you will have a roughness of RA 19.4. Yeah. Do you have any questions on this for now? Everything right? Here you have a few other possibilities. Measure extensions, the widths, the radius, the diameter, the angles, z height, and radius. Consider almost every measurement which you want to do, you can do here. So I would like to show a few of your samples.
Yes.
You have some. So.
Is
it possible to see real reaction on the sounding?
You get two videos.
Don't touch my watch.
you need the roughness of this, right?
Roughness, the actually doesn't analyze, for example, the dimension and how often the pulse. So how it's affecting, yes. This is the base rate, just to try to say.
I will do it first with this magnification, then we can go deeper. This is 400 magnification. So now he's doing again the image taking. In this case, high magnification. So now he's using 6 microns.
And we need to see what is the
loss.
I want to measure the image of the
yes. Actually,
the measurement of the
one like this, we are calling like the transition. This is C.
Yeah,
okay. Because when you just take one additional image, you see it and bounce like this.
For example,
this one three times.
I will say that.